Good Friday morning, John chapter 13. A new commandment I give you, that you love one another just as I have loved you. You also are to love one another. By this, all people will know that you are my disciples, if you have love one for another. What Nikki Gumbel shares today from this passage is something that has been brewing in my soul for months. I can do no better than just to read word for word what Nikki says about love in the church. Quote, "Nothing is more of a hindrance to the message of Jesus than a lack of love between Christians. If our nations are to be changed, if people are going to turn back to following Jesus, we must start loving one another. This means loving Christians of different churches, denominations, traditions, and different views to ourselves. It means loving one another in the local church. Disunity destroys. Love unites. Love attracts others to the person of Jesus. Loving God and loving one another in Jesus' name must be our overall ambition above all others. This is the kind of love that can change the world. People fail to love for different reasons. Judas betrayed Jesus in spite of being so very close to him. He who shared my bread has lifted up his heel against me, Jesus said. Satan entered into Judas, and here we see the very opposite of love. Judas hated love. He was in revolt against Jesus, and yet Jesus continued to love Judas. Jesus sets before you this amazing challenge. As I have loved you, so you must love one another. Jesus loved you by laying down his life for you. He says that you are to follow his example and show self-sacrificial love. This is the mark of a true Christian. By this will everyone know that you are my disciples, if you love one another. Love is the most effective form of evangelism. When people see real love, they see God. The best way to start telling people about Jesus is to love them and to love other followers of Jesus. Generally, in the world, people get into groups with people that they're naturally attracted to and who think the same way as them. We are meant to be quite different. The Church of Jesus Christ brings us together with a variety of people from different backgrounds, different interests, different ages, ethnicities, races, perspectives, lifestyles, opinions, and different worldviews, all who love one another. Lord, help us to love one another as you have loved us. May we see a new love between Christians of all churches, denominations, and traditions in the local, national, and global church. May the world be changed by our love. Good word for the day. God bless you. I'll see you tomorrow.